businesses should play a role in funding public transit. KPIX 5's Jackie Ward is live in Palo Alto on the transit tax that's sparking much discussion about who should pay up for reliable buses. Morning, Jackie.
Good morning, Mark. If approved, this tax would be the second tax imposed on local businesses within the last 7 years here in Palo Alto. The money would be used for various transportation projects, including ones that would hopefully improve traffic problems. And because this would be a local tax, the city would be able to control how the money was spent. A specially appointed council committee did some polls recently that showed 2/3 of voters support the measure, but it is getting some pushback from local businesses. So how much would those businesses have to pay up? Well, businesses with fewer than 10 employees would be exempt. Those with 10 to 50 employees would pay $50 per person. And businesses bigger than 50 people would pay $100 per employee. So now if the council does vote to move this measure forward, it would then be placed on the November ballot for Palo Alto voters to decide on. In Palo Alto, Jackie Ward, KPIX 5.
So Jackie, besides the additional cost, what other concerns are there?
Vice Mayor Greg Sharp is one of those people who's a little skeptical about this proposed tax because he wants more city outreach to be done. He also wants more details on the projects the city has in mind where they'll use this money. Back to you.
All right. Thank you, Jackie. Today's